कृष्णवर्णं तिशाकृष्णं साङ्गोपाङ्गास्त्रपार्षदं यज्ञैः संकीर्तनप्रायैर्यजन्ति सुमेधसः अन्तः कृष्णं बहिर्गौरं दर्शिताङ्गादिवैभवम् कलौ संकीर्तनाद्यै स्मः कृष्ण चैतन्यमाश्रिता जयतां मथुरा भूमौ श्रीलरूप सनातनौ यौ विलेकयतस्तत्त्वं ज्ञापकौ पुस्तिकामिमां कोऽपि तद्बान्धवो भट्टो दक्षिणद्विजवंशजः विविच्य वेलिकद्ग्रन्थं लिखिताद्वृद्धवैष्णवैः तस्याद्यं ग्रन्थनालेकं क्रान्तव्युत्क्रान्तखण्डितं पर्यालोच्यातपर्यायं कृत्वा लिखति जीवकः यः श्रीकृष्णपादाम्भोजा भजनेकाभिलाषवान् तेनैव दृश्यतामेतदन्यस्मै शपथोऽर्पितः श्रीमद्भागवतं श्रीमान् शन्त्रदेशिकमीश्वरं श्रीमद्भागवतार्थानां सन्दर्भं कर्तुमाश्रये अतनत्वा मन्त्रगुरून् गुरून् भागवतार्थतान् श्रीभागवतसन्दर्भं सन्दर्भं वश्मि लेखितुम् यस्य ब्रह्मेति संज्ञां क्वचिदपि निगमेयाति चिन्मात्रसत्ता यंशो यस्यांशकैस्वैर्विभवति वशयन्नेव मायां पुमांश्च एकं यस्यैव रूपं विलसति परमव्योम्नि नारायणाख्यम् स श्रीकृष्णो विधत्तां स्वयमिह भगवान् प्रेम तत्पादभाजाम् हरे कृष्ण हाउ आर यू फाइन नॉट फाइन हाउ इज गोइंग ऑन हाउ इज गोइंग विथ योर असाइनमेंट व्हाट इज गोइंग हाउ Writing. Yes. Nicely you are writing. Yeah, you are all good. Yesterday we discussed various examples for the six criteria, actually criteria for the for saying pratyaksha as a servant of shabda. That means four items, so we give the examples. Then after that also we cover Anumana Pramana, the process of the Anumana Pramana. We did this. So just I want to give some just clarification. In the case of Pratyaksha, we have seen several examples. For example, Pratyaksha, whatever Pratyaksha, according to its capacity, it follows the Shabda. What is the example we give? Fire is a treatment for the cold that we give. And after that, Shabda can overrule the Pratyaksha. What is the example for this? Snake biting. Snake bite. So this And also we give one more for the shabda, pratyaksha follows. Pratyaksha follows the shabda. It cannot oppose. Pratyaksha cannot oppose. Golden ashes. Golden ashes. Or gold ashes. Sorry, not golden. Gold ashes. Smarana bhasma. This example we give. Yeah. So what I am saying, all these examples, whatever we have given, sometimes that example may be suitable to describe the two features also, like the overruling and also supporting. So then there is no problem actually. Example means example. Example is not necessary that everything should match with the whatever to be exemplified. Okay? So like, for example, we gave the Urnanabi. You know Urnanabi? Urnanabi means spider. So like, spider is the upadhana karanam and the nimitta karanam for the creating the web. Web, whatever web is created. So for the creation of the web, spider is the upadhana and also nimitta. What is the meaning of upadhana and nimitta? Upadhana means the content, that means the material actually. For example, if you want to make a pot, so what is the upadhana karanam? Clay is the upadhana karanam and the stick is the nimitta karanam. Yeah, nimitta karanam. Stick is the nimitta karanam. Person is also nimitta karanam. Wheel is also nimitta karanam. These are all the nimitta karanams. So for making the web, so cobweb, so for that web, spider is the upadana and the nimitta both. So similarly, Supreme Lord is upadana karanam and also nimitta karanam for this material creation. Yes? So here we are comparing, that means like how the spider is the cause for the web, in the same way Krishna, we said. So here example is what? Spider is example. And who is exemplified? Krishna is exemplified. So we should not try to, so now we should not try to see every feature in the object to be exemplified. That means every feature of the example, we should not compare with the object which is exemplified. So for example, spider is eating the some insects. So that means, oh, in the example, spider is eating the insects, so also Krishna also will eat the insects. Such a conclusions can we bring? No, we cannot do such a conclusions actually. So that means it, in the example means it is just is given to make you to understand the object to be exemplified nicely. So that much feature only, in the example you have to see that much feature only, which is the author is want to mention. That much only you should see. But you should not go with the other features of the that example, and you should not impose those features with the object to be exemplified. Understanding or not? So this is a philosophy of the example. Generally, example means we like this. So it's just it's a basic understanding. Anyone actually, so yeah, should know this. So similarly here, now shabda is overriding the pratyaksha, overrules the pratyaksha. So that is said. What is the example for that? That snake bite. So there, what is happening? Example I am saying, there the snake bitten him. Then after that, so poison is went into his body. That is clearly indicating that is a black mark will happen on this. The mantrik came and he just cured it. He pronounced mantra, and that mantra is saying that. So no poison. Here what? Whatever pratyaksha is said is true. At the moment before applying the the mantra, it is true. But here, after that, shabda you, that means shabda came and the mantra came and mantra cured that removed that poison. So, but this is not seen by the pratyaksha. This is not seen by the pratyaksha. And now here pratyaksha, whatever it produced, that knowledge is now what happened is suppressed, or it is so overruled, actually overruled by the shabda. Why it is overruled? Because pratyaksha is not having such a capacity, so that it is not independent, or otherwise it is not so self illuminating, so at any moment it can so give the right knowledge. No, so at any moment it can give right knowledge means even after applying mantra, so we are not seeing that effect of the mantra directly through the pratyaksha. That is the limitation of the pratyaksha. So and shabda came and it overruled that. Okay, this is the inner thing. So here this example we took, this snake bite. Now if this example is fitting to any another place, that means pratyaksha follows the shabda, so with other angle, so if that is possible, then there is no problem in that, actually. So that's my point, is one example can be useful to explain many features, many criterias. That is the point that can be possible. So but just you have to think, when you are going to write your assignment, at that time you have to think, so okay, this is the feature, this is the criteria I want to explain, that means, and then that criteria is there in this example or not. Maybe that example is having so many other features also, that's no problem, like that. Now one more point. So okay, that is done. So next we were discussing the anumana pramana. What are the different steps in the anumana pramana? How many are there? 5. Everyone can answer, actually. What is the first one? Statement, pratigna. Next, hetu. Online students also can. No, then it will be like a shouting, actually. Okay, second one is hetu. Third one is, fourth one is application, fifth one is conclusion. So these are the 5 steps. In this, what happens first, actually, what we are going to make, we are going to observe the relation between the hetu and the sadhya. Process, in the process, statement we declare, actually. What is that statement? Hill is fiery. This is a statement we promised. Yes, now hill is fiery. That you have to prove. That is a pratigna. Hill is fiery. Now to prove hill is fiery, so first, what is the hetu you are taking? That means hill is fiery. That means hill, on the top of the hill, there is fire. So now you want to find the fire. Main thing is what? Anyway, hill is there already. There is no need to find the hill. But what we need to find? Hill is fiery. That means fire is on the hill. That we need to find. Okay? That means fire is our the goal. Hey, fire is? This is sadhya. Actually, it is the goal. That is a goal to find. That's why we say fire as what in Sanskrit term? Sadhya. That should be achieved, na? What do you want? You to say hill is fiery, what you need to find? What do you need to find for? That means fire. To say hill is fiery, what we need to establish? So there is a fire on the hill. That should be done. So that means fire you should find. To find the fire, so who can be the best hetu? Water is the hetu. Wherever there is a water, there is a fire. Can you say like this? So otherwise, pot, you can say, wherever there is a pot, there is a fire. Can you say? Why not? Why can't you say pot is the hetu for the fire? No. So, to make a hetu, what is the criteria? If you want to make someone as a hetu to find another one, what criteria should be followed? Here? No, not experience. Here, what is his name? You want to say something? No. What is that relation? Now I am asking, fire, you have to find, na, to say hill is fiery. So now to find the fire, whom you can make the hetu? That means cause, or the hetu. Hetu means reason. Whom you can make? I want to make water. That means, I will find the water on the hill and then I'll say there is a fire. What is the problem? Take the mic and tell.
Because the relationship between fire and the water is not avyabhachari.
What is this? Avyabhachari is very difficult to understand.
They can exist. They can be water without fire. In simple words, they can be water.
There can be water without
fire.
Fire. Okay, very good. Good. So, then what is the such item which we can use as a hetu to find the fire? So that is his smoke. And whatever he said, that is a correct answer. So that's why here, if you see the, if you make a Venn diagram, Venn diagrams, you know, na? This is Vyapya subset, and this is Vyapaka. This is Vyapaka. So what we can use to find what in this? We can use Vyapya to find the Vyapaka. You can use Vyapya to find the Vyapaka. Yes? You're not getting, na? Yes. So here, Vyapya Vyapaka Sambandha. Let us take this superset is example I will give. Is Indians. All Indians is a superset. And subset of this is Uttar Pradeshi. Uttar Pradeshi. The person who residing in Uttar Pradesh is known as Uttar Pradeshi. So for everyone's understanding, I am saying Uttar Pradesh is the one state out of India, actually is one state in India. So all the citizens who are living in India are known as Indians, and whoever in that India, there is one state, and that state is Uttar Pradesh, and whoever is living in Uttar Pradesh is known as Uttar Pradeshian. Okay. So now you can say like this, all the Uttar Pradeshians are the Indians. Yes or no? So, and but the, all the Indians are Uttar Pradeshian. Can you say? No. Okay. So now, if you want to find any Indian, so that means if you want to find Indian, you can use Uttar Pradeshian as a hetu. Yes. If he is Uttar Pradeshian, definitely he is Indian. But you cannot use, so in the reverse, that means you cannot say every Indian is Uttar Pradeshian. Yes. So that's why I'm saying here, for example, that means Uttar Pradeshian can be used as a hetu to find the so Indian. So like this, and the superset and subset concept is like this. Now come to our main place. Now you went to kitchen. You went to kitchen. In the kitchen, you are finding the smoke, and also you are finding the fire. This is smoke, and this is fire. Kitchen you take, okay? Smoke is there, fire is there. And you went to the cow shed. There also, smoke is there. Fire is there, yes or no?
Yes.
And also after that, you went to sleeping place. Okay, in the winter season, sleeping place. Yesterday I was saying example. In the village, all the people, they sleep and they keep the, so the they keep the wood and fire. So they, there also you'll be finding smoke and fire. And you come to the, so karkhana, that means factory. In the factory, especially in the case of the, that red hot, so that iron rod, it is kept in the fire, so it became red hot. In that case, are you finding the smoke? No, but fire is there. So that's why here, you see, the number of places of existence of this smoke is lesser than the number of places of the existence of fire. Yes? So that's why the number of places of existence of smoke are lesser than the number of places of existence of fire. Huh? So that's why you can use fire, you can use smoke as the hetu to find the fire. You can use smoke as a hetu to find the fire. Also, in another case, the number of places of existence of the prithvitvam, prithvitvam and gandhatvam. Gandhatvam. And next is prithvitvam. Prithvitvam. Gandhatvam means what? Smell. No, gandhatvam is gandha. Okay. Gandha you take. Gandha you take. Smell. Okay, smell. And prithvitvam means earthness. Earthness. So what we know, just to try to understand, it little bit, it is nayayika words, but try to understand. Here smell, where smell exists? Where the earthness exists? Wherever there is smell. You know or not? While the creation, first what is created? First is sound. From the sound, ether came. Sky or ether. And next from the ether, touch. And from the, after that, air. From the touch, air came. Then after that, form. Then fire. Then after that, taste. Then after that, water. Then gandha, smell. Then after that, earth. So this is the sequence. You see, this smell is existing out of five elements. That means the sky, air, water, fire, water, and earth. Sky is having the, what is the quality in the sky? Sky is having the sound, quality is sound. Air is having the sound and touch. Fire is having the sound, touch, and form. Water, sound, touch, form, and taste. Earth is having the sound, touch, form, taste, and smell. So now smell is existing in how many of these? Smell is existing all. Only earth. So that's why now what I say here, smell, this smell is there, na? Wherever there is a smell, that means now take the earth. In this earth, what is there? Guna, what is the guna? This is earth you take. In the earth, what is the guna is there? Smell is there, and also prithvitvam is there. Earthness is there or not in the earth? Earthness means prithvitvam. Ghata means, like manushya, why he is known as manusha? He is having what? Manushyatvam. Like the pot, pot is having the ghatatvam, potness. Yes, like this earth is having the earthness, that is known as prithvitvam. Prithvitvam is a quality. It's like manushyatvam. What is manushyatvam? So no, that is not smell. So now this is a property. This is a gandha. So this is gandha. Smell means gandha. These two are existing in equal places, because smell is not existing other than the earth. So that's why earthness and smell, these both are the both are in equally existing. Wherever there is earth, there is smell. So that's why to find the earth, you can use the smell as a hetu, and to find the earthness, you can use the smell as the hetu. Yes, if they are equally available, you can use either as the hetu and another as sadhya. Getting or not? Generally, hetu should be what? Who is existing in the less number of places? That should be the hetu. And which is existing in the more number of places? That should be the sadhya. So you cannot use the one which is existing in the more number of places as the hetu to find the one existing which is in the less number of places. Okay, clear? Or if both are existing in equal number of places, then you can use anyone to as anyone as a hetu and anyone as sadhya. This point is clear. So now that's why the one which is existing in the number less number of places, that's why I set it as a sub inside, and the one which is existing in the more number of places, it is the outside, actually bigger one. It's a bigger one. So that's why you can use this the one which is existing in the less number of places. Example is a smoke. So that's why you can use smoke, but you cannot use the water as the hetu to find the fire. Because water is existing in the so many places where there is no fire. Like water is like this, and sometimes actually no, they are both are opposite. So they are like this. This is water and this is fire. This is water and this is fire. You cannot use water to find the fire. Because there is no connection, means there is an anti connection is there, and opposite connection is there. Wherever there is water, there is no fire. So that's why you cannot use this one as a hetu. Asiddha hetu, this is asiddha. It cannot accomplish asiddha. So hetus also several types actually. So this is. And sometimes it is like this. Can you see any two items so that some overlapping is there and some non-overlapping is also there? Can you see any one example? Like you see water and fire both are opposite, and so they don't have any common place to exist. So can you say two items such a way they have some common place and some independent place also? But they are like this na. Smoke is existing. That is a different actually. So simple example you tell. Like this. What I am asking. Sometimes, what is that? Arini. Now you leave the fire and the smoke, you have so many other things. Mike.
Like a citizenship. Citizenship. Some people can have only Indian citizenship, some can have American, and some can have both the citizenship.
Good. This is example. someone have the only Indian citizenship, someone have the American citizenship, someone can have the both. Like this I am asking. So there are so many like this. Aquatics and
land. Some species they live in both
amphibious and aquatics.
Aquatics.
So some like the frog, if you like, take,
yeah,
it is land, living on the land, and also it is and the water. It comes under both. This is the area. So like this. So here, whoever is having this kind of relationship, any two items have this kind of relation. In this case also, you cannot use as one as the hetu to another. Yes, because here this is a place. Yes, so the here both are having the common place. Then in this case it is okay. But here you see it is existing independent. Indian ship is existing. Indian is independent to the American citizenship. That's why you cannot say whoever is Indian, he is American. Can you say like that? No. Whoever is having Indian citizenship, he is also having the American citizenship. Can you say like this? No. So that's why you cannot use this as a hetu to this one. So when we can use one as another as hetu, this is. So one is and is vyapya, and another is the vyapaka. So then you can use the vyapya. Vyapya means which is covered, and vyapaka means which covers. Or otherwise, this is also possible. Both are in the equal. Like this, this both two complete overlap. Complete example is prithvitvam and gandhatvam. Prithvitvam and gandhatvam. Gandha. Prithvitvam and gandha. This. Okay, clear. So that's why now you have to find the fire. On the hill is fiery. So what is the best? That means what is the hetu for that? For that hetu is smoke. Because smoke is existing in the less number of places, and that's avyabhichari also is the same. Avyabhichari means what? This, since the items which are in this are becoming this also and also becoming this, so that's why this, the items which are in this are the avyabhichari towards this, but not the in the reverse order. You cannot say in the reverse. But if you say it like this, that means two are in the overlapping, then the items in the one are the avyabhichari with the others, both vice versa mitaha. Yes, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Krishna, mitaha avyabhicharatvam is there. Whenever Krishna comes in the Dwapara Yuga, in the next immediate Kali Yuga, so Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is coming. You can also see in the reverse. If you came to know, that means in this Kali Yuga Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came, then you can immediately guess that in the previous Dwapara Yuga, Krishna is there. Krishna was there. And if you come to know one thing, that means in this Dwapara Yuga, Krishna appeared, means definitely you can say that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is in the next Kali Yuga. Because both having the avyabhichara, samana, that means they are like prithvi, tvam and gandaha. That means vice versa, avyabhicharitvam they have. So now we can use smoke as a fire. Smoke as a hetu to find the fire. So that is a hetu. Then after that, we can see the example. Example is what? Where we can see the example. That means fire, smoke can be used as a hetu for the fire. So where we can find this? Kitchen, yeah. Kitchen or the kostam, that means cow shed, or otherwise that's a sleeping place, like this. Anyone we can take. Okay, then after that, so from the example what we got after observing this, yatra yatra dumaha tatra tatra vahini, this kind of rule we achieved by seeing the various examples. What we derived? Yatra yatra dumaha tatra tatra vahini, this kind of relation we firmly developed. So that's why this kind of strong relation is possible, because the main reason is smoke is generated is only and only by fire. That's why this relationship is possible. That what kind of relation? Yatra yatra dumaha tatra tatra vahini, this you can say, because so smoke can be generated by only fire. This is the reason. Okay, next, After that, udaharana we saw, then we have to apply. Now you come to the your hill where you want to find the fire. So now you will be searching for first what? If you come to hill to establish hill is fiery, first you, what you need to search? Hetu you should search, fire, not fire. Hetu you should search first. Yes, hetu is there. That means fire is, the smoke is there on the top of the hill. So now you saw that there is smoke. Then after that, yes, you will apply the yatra yatra dhumaha tatra tatra vahini, this rule. So immediately then you will come to the conclusion. So there is fire. So this is the process, and even this process also will be having a fault. This process is also having the fault. That we have to see. Vyapaka is the which covers. Vyapya is which is covered. Covers means which is in the superset is known as vyapaka, which is in the subset is known as vyapya. So samana. Samana vyapti, vishama vyapti. So if hetu and sadhya is having this kind of relationship, then it is known as vishama vyapti. Not equal. Vishama means not equal. Hetu and sadhya. Sadhya is what? Fire. Fire is sadhya. That means whom you want to find. That is known as sadhya. And what you are going to use to find the sadhya, that is known as hetu. So now hetu always should be in the less number of places, and sadhya should be in the more number of places. And that's why this vyapti, this kind of vyapti means existence of hetu and the sadhya is known as vyapti. So how it should be? It should be the, if it is like this, then it is vishama vyapti. What is that? Vishama vyapti. That is not vyapti. No vyapti is there because they are independent. And if this is like this, this is, that means gandaha and the prithvitvam, both are equal, then it is known as samavyapti. What is it? Samavyapti. Gandaha and prithvitvam, they are having the samavyapti. No heart. Time waste. It's just repeated from the last class. Nothing is matching. Asiddha. Asiddha hetu. If you use that as a hetu, then asiddha hetu. Water and the fire. Yeah. There are so many things are in the Tarka Sangraha, it is very detailedly explained. So if you learn at least Tarka Sangraha, it will be good actually. To your logic brain will start functioning. Once logic brain start functioning, then you can easily, you can use logic to understanding the Vedic statements. To interpret the Vedic meanings, you need to, you can use the logic. You cannot use logic to establish. You cannot use logic as an independent tool as to establish the Krishna. You cannot use it. It is because it is not having the capacity to establish Krishna. But you can use logic to understand the Vedic statements, to interpret the Vedic statements, Sruti Vakyas. So that's why Vyada Vyasa is saying, coming in the next Anushadha, it will become Tarka Pratishthanat. Tarka by itself is not pratishtita. That means by itself it cannot do, independently it cannot tell about the absolute truth. But tarka can be just useful. Use is assistant. We are going to see, like the pratyaksha pramana is also assistant for the shabda pramana. Similarly, tarka is also assistant for the shabda. So like this, you can use tarka also as assistant. If you learn the tarka, so what is useful? You can make it as assistant for your shabda and you can use it. Not establishing scriptures. To understand the whatever said in the scriptures. Because scriptures are the self-illuminating. Vedas are self-illuminating. Bhagavatam is self-illuminating. It doesn't need any other one help to tell about himself. It itself is sufficient, actually. Fine. But others may just assist. They can assist their soul. It's a king already, and these are all servants. So now come, how the there is a fault in this, we'll see in the anumana, this process. So pratigna, hetu, udaharana, upanayana, upanaya, and nigamana. If you come to our yes. Where is it? Page 4. Yeah, in notes. Atha pratigna hetu udaharana upanaya nigama abhida panchangam anumanam yat tadapi vibicharati. Panchangam anumanam yat tadapi vibicharati. Tatra vishama vyaptau. Vishama vyapti means you understood, na? This is a vishama vyapti. Sadhya is existing in more number of places and sa hetu is existing in less. That is known as vishama vyapti. Our fire and the smoke, they have what kind of vyapti? Vishama vyapti. Tatra vishama vyaptau yatha vrushtya tatkala nirvapita vahunau charam adikoditvara dhume parvate parvatoyam vahiniman ityadau ityadau. Prabhu, you have another sketch? Okay. Okay. It's okay. In the Pratyaksha Pramana, we saw Pratyaksha Gnanam is Vyabhichari towards its Prameya. We understood or not that? What is the example we give? Pratyaksha Gnanam is Vyabhichari towards its Prameya. What is the example we give? Huh? What is that? You are all not preparing. Not writing no assignment. Yes, what is that? Pratyaksha. Pratyaksha Jnanam is a vyabhichari towards his prameya. What is the example? Mayamundam. Yes, Mayamundam. In the Mayamundam case, what happened? That magician created a Devadatta's head and Somadatta saw that head and he was thinking that it is Devadatta's head. But actually it is not Devadatta's real head. Okay. So that means there the knowledge, whatever is produced, this is Devadatta's head. This knowledge is becoming Vibhichari towards its Prameya. So if Prameya is there, then the same knowledge has to be produced by that Pramana. But and then that Jnana will be same. That means it's Avyabhichari. But here Jnana, Pratyaksha Jnanam is not Avyabhichari because Pratyaksha Pramanam is itself having some fault. That's why. Yes, we understood or not? This is the Devadatta's head and this is the Pratyaksha Pramana and this is the Jnanam, Pratyaksha Jnanam. This is Pratyaksha Jnanam. So this is Devadatta's head. This is Devadatta's head. This is generated from the Pratyaksha Pramana. And this is the Prameya. What is that Prameya? Is the false head. In the case of false head, what kind of knowledge has to be produced? This is not Devadatta's head. Or this is the, so not Devadatta's head. This kind of knowledge has to be produced, but it is not produced. But what kind of knowledge is produced? This is Devadatta's head. This kind of knowledge is produced. And that's why. So this knowledge is becoming Vibhichari towards this. Because of reason is what? So knowledge is having any fault? No. But knowledge is produced by this Pramana. So that's why this Pramana is having defect in this. That is the cause to become this knowledge to be Vibhichari towards this Prameya. So similarly here also, the Anumana process. Now you just instead of the Pratyaksha, then you keep the Anumana in that. this is anumana pramanam, this is anumiti gnanam, and this is the prameya. Okay, this is the prameya. And this is anumana pramanam. That means the five limb process is known as, total is known as anumana pramanam. And this is, what is this? Anumiti gnanam. Prema? Prama? No, it is of course Prama, but it is generated by the Anumana Pramana. That's why it is known as Anumiti Gnanam. Anumiti Gnanam, every Anumiti Gnanam is not necessary to become Prama. Every Pratyaksha Pratyaksha Gnanam is not necessary to become Prama. Yes? In the case of this, is in the rope, you are seeing the rope and by your eyes, and you are coming to the, you are getting the knowledge, this is snake. So this is snake, is the Prama or the Brahma? Brahma. But it is the Pratyaksha Gnanam only, but it is Brahma. So that's why every Pratyaksha Gnanam is not the Prama. Similarly, every Anumana, Anumiti Gnanam is not Prama. So now just that's why I write Anumiti Gnanam here. So now here, Prameya, Prameyam, what is the Prameyam here? Now the hill is there, okay? Hill is there and there smoke is there. And rain came. Rain came, okay? And you are here. Okay, Anumana Pramana is with you, na? So you are here, okay. So this is the hill, and just some forest fire raised there, and there is a lot of smoke. And just before coming to that hill, before you come to that hill, so just a little rain came and it extinguished total fire, but still there is smoke. Now you came in this situation. So in the situation you came. Then you are seeing the smoke. And then after that, so on the top of this hill, you are seeing the smoke. Then after that, what? You'll immediately recall the what? Yatra yatra dhumaha tatra tatra vahini. So you recall this rule. Then after that, you will be coming to the conclusion. So on this hill, there is a smoke, and I know that yatra yatra dhumaha tatra tatra vahini. That means wherever there is a smoke, there is a fire. So then after that, what is the conclusion you are getting? There is a fire. Who is saying no fire? So there is a fire on the hill. But actually, there is fire on hill. This is the what? This is Anumiti Gnanam. Anumiti. There is fire on hill. Okay. So this Gnanam is Prama or the Brahma. There is a fire on hill. This is Prama or the Brahma? Is it right knowledge? It's not right knowledge. Yeah. Are you didn't see rain? Rain came, Prabhu, just little bit before you reach to that hill. No, was there. So, no, good, smoke only is there. Yeah. So that means Here actually what is happening, you are seeing this smoke and finally coming to the conclusion that there is a fire on the hill, and but this is not the, it's a true knowledge, it's not the right knowledge. So that's why here, so this jnanam, this anumiti jnanam is becoming vibhichari towards this, because this process, so ultimately is not leading, this anumana pramanam, this process is not leading to the right knowledge. So that's why this knowledge became vibhichari towards its pramaya. Okay. Anyone is thinking, why Prabhu you are explaining all this this fire, this, that, and so that too, we are devotees, chant Hare Krishna, be happy. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. So this is enough. But actually, see, if you really got that faith, that kind of taste in the ruchi pradana, devotees are two types, vichara pradana and ruchi pradana. If you have, if you already achieved the ruchi in the holy name completely, so that means, and you have, that means ruchi means not that there only one day ekadasi you have ruchi and after that not having ruchi. No, if you have continuous ruchi, and then there is no need to study all this shastra and everything. There is no need actually. Directly that kind of devotee can engage. But whoever is not having that, but to develop the shraddha thoroughly, and then we need to read the shastras. To read the shastras, you can use the logic to understand. That means to understand the shastra. So that's why, so that thorough understanding of shastra will lead to the shraddha, and shraddha will be the foundation for the vaidhi bhakti, or that's sadhana bhakti. Okay, that's why vaidhi bhakti. So that's why we just having the, all the time our mind, whenever we try to understand, and if you feel difficulty, immediately we'll get this dog, this kind of thought. Why we need, why we need, why we need, don't, no need, no need, no need. Yeah. Oh, okay. Like how the Vyabhicharita is came, you understood. So this first point is what? Out of six, first criteria is, so this anumana, here what you have to take? You have to take two. So anumana pramanam, and who is another? Anumana pramanam and versus? Shabda. Anumana pramanam, non-defective shabda. Versus? No. First one is Vyabhichari. And this is, that we have to show now. Vyabhichari. This Vyabhichari we proved already. This is how the Anumana Pramana became Vyabhichari. Yes, this is. That means the rain came, but you didn't see that. And you are seeing only smoke. By seeing that smoke, you came to the conclusion that there is fire. So, but that is not correct. So, tatra vishama vyaptau yatha vrushtya tatkala nirvapita vahno. So, chiram adiko ditvara dhume parvate parvatoyam vahiniman ityado varshasu dhumayamanam swabhave parvateva. And once, sometimes, this is the one case, and maybe another case is also there. That means to get the false anumiti jnanam, there is one more situation I am saying, one more situation I am explaining. This is the hill, and now it's about to rain. So sometimes about to rain, what will be happening? These clouds all will be coming, though, close, and it will look misty. What do we say that? Mist. In the rainy season, the mountain may have lots of mist that looks like smoke. And after that, by seeing that mist, you will be thinking that it is original smoke, and you will be coming to the conclusion that there is fire. But this is also, this jnanam is also Vyabhichari. So that's why for vyabhichari, to say anumana pramana vyabhichari, one is rain case and another is mist. Two we took. Next, natu shabdaha. But shabda is not vyabhichari. Example I am taking. What is that? Suryakantat sauramarichi yogena agnir uttishtate. So we are hearing the statement. What is that statement? Shabda means statement actually. Suryakanta saura marichi yogena agnir uttishtate. What is English translation? Tell, read. Fire arises from sunstone by contact with sun rays. This is what? This is shabda you are hearing. You know Suryakantamani? Suryakantamani and Chandrakantamani? There are two manis are there. In the world, it's really there, it's not imaginary. Real Suryakanta. This is Suryakantamani. And Chandrakantamani is also there. Or otherwise, mani, it may be like this. Yeah, maybe. So these manis, this Suryakanta money, what it does? If you keep this money, so in the sunlight, then you will be getting the fire from that. If you just not reflection, it immediately you will be getting the fire. This Suryakanta money. Yeah. No, it will not burn. It will be money only, but fire keep on coming. So when the sun rays fall on this, by touching, that means when sun rays touches, then fire will be there. So it will be as it is only. Money will not be burnt out. No. And Chandrakanta Mani is another property it is having. This Chandrakanta Mani, there is a fire now you take. So if you keep Chandrakanta Mani in that fire, no, so fire will be there, but if you touch that fire, there will be no, it will not burn you. So they can use it. Fire engine people, they can use. They can make a jacket with the Chandrakanta monies, and they can just go inside the fire. Yeah, this is the Chandrakanta money actually. So now what you are hearing is a statement, Suryakanta Mani produces fire when it is touched by sun rays. And also you can see in the pratyaksha. So is there any, that means after hearing what knowledge you are getting this statement? Oh, okay, Suryakanta Mani produces fire when it is touched by the sun rays. So there is no mistake in that. There is no fault in that. So knowledge always same is produced from that line. Suryakanta Mani produces. Next, tat sab. It's not for defeating Anuman. It is just is one example to say that means Shabda Gnanam is always avyabhichari. How the Shabda Gnanam is avyabhichari? So here also you could take. This is Shabda Pramanam. Like here, what Anumana? You take Pramanam here. Pramanam you take here, and then after that, here Gnanam you take, generated by Pramanam, and here you should take what? Prameyam. Prameyam you take. Now we are hearing the state. What is the here? Pramana is what in the case of Shabda, this Suryakanta Mani, what is the Pramanam here? Suryakanta Mani. Suryakanta Mani produces fire when it is touched by sun rays. This is statement, combination of different words, and these statements are producing the knowledge that Suryakanta Mani. The same, whatever his statement is, that knowledge only you'll get. Yes? That knowledge you got. This is the knowledge produced. That means here, Suryakanta Mani produces fire when it is touched by sun rays. Okay. This is the knowledge you produced. About what? What is the Pramaya? Is the Suryakantamani. Yes. Suryakantamani. Now, this Shabda Pramana is always producing the same knowledge. Yeah. But in the case of Anumana Pramana, that's a 5-step process. So produced wrong knowledge. There is a fire on the hill. Even there is no fire. This is produced. That's why this knowledge is becoming vebichari towards this Pramaya. But this knowledge, this is Shabda Gnanam, is not vebichari towards this.
Huh. That Himalaya consists Hima and so Himalaya having him, barf is there in Himalaya. So that example was there. So this is that example, same example can
you can take here also, no problem.
Why the another example?
Yeah,
is
no problem. You can take
different something different.
No, no difference. You can take that also.
Same.
Anything you can, any shabda. Okay, next. Now, tat shabdena baddha moolam yatha. And also now, next second point is what? So this is first, vebichari avyabichari concept is clear. That means how the anumana pramanam is vebichari and this shabda is the avyabichari. That is clear? Out of six, first one. Yes, yes, yes. Same we will see for the anumana also. Six. Six criteria we will see once again. Second is dependent. It is independent. That we should prove. That we should discuss now. So come to the hill case only. Now you see here, now you have two hills. How many? Two. You are here. In between. Are Shetaduraha Patikaha Masmin Dhumad Vahni Sambhavanam Krudvam Drishtam Asmabihi Atra Asau Prishtyadhuna Eva Nirvanaha Kintu Amutreva Dhumad Garani Giro Drishyate Vahnihi. Sadhguru Prabhu, what is the English translation of this line? Tell me. Notes. I will ask whoever is not following. Sadhguru Prabhu, you are okay? You cannot, you can say or not? You cannot. You can? You cannot. That means you are not able to follow. Rangamaya Prabhu, tell me. What is English translation? I will take the mic, give mic to him.
O traveler, suffering from cold, you should not expect existence of fire from seeing a smoke on this hill. You have just seen that the fire has been extinguished by rain.
Sadhguru Prabhu, you sit with someone who is following, so they can help tomorrow onwards. So you have to sit with Rangamaya Prabhu and follow what is going on. So now you see, you are here. And you are seeing the smoke on this hill. And you are thinking, now that is a winter season actually. It's a winter season. and now you are going on the, that means some far distance, you want to reach to some Himalayas actually. From the here to Himalayas you are traveling. So, but on that day, so much cold is there. So you are shivering. So now, but you don't have any other alternative. You are seeing the smoke on this hill. Then after seeing the smoke, you and your friends also there. Not only you are not going alone. Your friends also there. All in a troop, you are going to the Himalayas. But in between, so now the night and very much cold. And you are not night, it is so. It's a daytime only. You are seeing the smoke. If it is night, then you cannot see the smoke. So you are feeling cold. So you want to take some rest. So now by seeing the smoke, then you are thinking that, oh, anyway, a lot of cold is there. We are shivering. So let us go to the top of this hill and get that some fire and so that we can wait for some time. So like that, you are all thinking. Then here one person is coming from here. Actually, he is here. So he is saying to you all, hey patikaha sitaturaha, that means hey pedestrians who travelers, so you are all shivering with the cold, and that means you are all walking this means in this route to reach this hill. So he understood, actually he is at the junction. There is a two routes like here and here he is. And now you are coming from this and you are going here, this direction. So then he came just here in the middle, in the junction he is. And he is saying, what? So don't go to this hill. You travelers who are suffering with the cold, don't go to this hill. Because just now, so what? Rain came and the fire is extinguished. Fire is extinguished and there is no fire on the top of hill. You go to this hill where you are seeing the nice smoke, and you go to this hill and there is fire. So then what? When you are here in this junction, when you saw the smoke on this top of hill, then what you thought? There is a fire on the top of hill. But now when you heard, but that is what? Whatever you got, that anumana gnanam, that means that anumiti gnanam, that is wrong. So now when you heard from this person who is already knowing about these two hills, and that person is saying that, so there is no fire and you go to this hill. So that means then you got the yes. Here also you are seeing the smoke, and then after that you also, from the anuman also you are getting there is fire. But before getting this knowledge, there is no fire on this hill, but there is a fire on this hill. This kind of clear, that means correct knowledge you got after hearing from that person. So that's why here anumiti gnanam is dependent on the shabda. Clear? Shyamanand Prabhu, you got it? Explain. Cue the mic. How to explain anumana pramana, anumiti gnanam is dependent on shabda gnana. Tell me.
Group of the people, they are feeling cold. And they saw from long distance that there is the mountain. There is smoke, some smoke. So they thought that there would be.
Hill number one and hill number two you take.
Hill number one. So while they are going there, so some visitors, some person told that, no, you don't go. Because there was a rain, that way that fire has been extinguished by the rain. You go to other mountain, then there is fire.
So this whole, how can you say anumiti gnanam is dependent on sabda gnanam? How can you say this from this? How
first this the students, the group, they were they are in anuman praman, so why they, when they hear the exact meaning, then that is covered.
That is
means
okay, it's okay. Okay,
that was not really real. The fact is that they get the fact thing from the visitors, then they went another place. That was the fact. Now, whatever that thing, that was the Anuman.
So that means these people came to know about this hill. That means there is a fire on this hill. So, and there is no fire on this hill, and there is a fire on this hill. Even though they both are hills are looking, having the smoke, but here there is no fire, and here there is a fire. So this kind of right conclusion they got after hearing from this person. Okay, that's why it is dependent. Yes.
Just little sidetrack, sorry. This person has pratyaksha gyan because he has seen that there is rain and no fire.
Who? This person? This person, yeah, he is having the pratyaksha gnana. He went to this hill also and he went to this hill also. He saw. But how these people got about the information about these two hills?
Sabda.
Sabda of him.
Sabda.
Yeah, that is already, that means properly verified one, that Shabda. That is not having any mistake. That's why we are taking. So, Brahmadi dosha rahita Shabda. So, whatever he is speaking is the Brahmadi dosha rahita Shabda. That we are considering. Okay, online students, you have any question? No, it is okay. 2 points. Okay. Yes, yes. Close it. Open it. Krishna Rup Mataji, tell. Ask.
Yeah, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, can we just give an analogy of these two hills as, you know, Anumati with the Shabda? Is that so? For example, I have never gone to New York. Okay. But somebody else has been.
New York?
I have never been to New York, for example. And I've never seen that particular place. But somebody who has been to that place, he comes and tells me, okay, there is a place existing called New York. And, you know, it's a nice place. You know, you can visit over there.
Okay. So his,
because he has seen Pratyaksha. He has seen that place Pratyaksha. He comes back and he tells me, okay, there's a place called New York existing. He gives me Shabda. And then I also go and visit that particular place. Is this analogy right for this particular Anumati to prove Shabda?
No. The main thing is what? We have how to prove. First of all, fix our goal actually. What is our goal? We have to establish Anumiti Gnanam is dependent on Shabda Gnanam. Shabda Gnanam. That is the main thing. It's okay. Not that the, so someone that means visiting from other, someone is giving the Shabda to you and you are getting. No, that is not the simple, that much is not happening. Here, what is happening? So these people, they are suffering with the cold and now they want fire. So they are seeing the smoke on both hills. Now, but they want to go to this hill, this near to them and they are going. But what they heard, that means how they are, why they are going to this hill? Because there is a smoke. And they come to conclusion that there is a fire. By the, they applied Anumana Pramana. So to these people applied Anumana Pramana to find fire on this hill based upon seeing smoke. But this is wrong. That means there is no fire. And here there is a fire. So this kind of knowledge these people got after hearing another, that means this right person.
From that particular person. Yeah.
So that means Shabda, this Shabda already. So these people, came to know that means this hill is not having any, this hill having fire and this is not having any fire. So then, so after that hearing this Shabda, so they can see the smoke and they can confirm that, yes, there is a fire. So that's why.
Thank you. You
understood now the Anumiti Gnanam, whatever is produced, what is that? There is fire on this hill and there is no fire on this hill. After the hearing from this person, that means after the Shabda they got, that's why it is, you know, that means Anumiti Gnanam is dependent on the
Shabda. So you can say in a particular area, there is Corona and there is no Corona. And then somebody comes and tells you, okay, here there is no Corona, you can go over here. And here there is Corona, so please don't go over here. Is that analogy right?
Fundamental point you are not catching actually. Anumiti is dependent on the Shabda. That point you have to mention, you have to remember. Here, these people are trying to apply their anumiti pramanam and trying to get the fire, trying to prove the fire on this. But they are coming to proper understanding that anumiti is functioning properly. So that means here there is no fire and here there is fire. That anumiti is properly functioning after, based upon what? Based upon the shabda.
Shabda.
Okay. Okay. Next question. Some other. Yeah.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yeah.
It's just a question regarding the, if we see there is smoke and there is no fire, can we just say that this is another example that proves that smoke can exist without fire? Like, for example, we have examples with sleeping place, with kitchen, with a factory. Can we just say it's another example which proves that smoke can exist without fire if we can see there is smoke right after the rain, which extinguished the fire? Can we just say that smoke is not a proper hetu for fire anymore? Does it make any sense?
Can you write and send?
So you see, we have so many examples where we see there is smoke and there is...
Not able to get your question, actually. So your accent and also the what he's asking, you want to explain? Yeah. Can you?
So we see there are so many... Okay. There are so many different...
He's explaining your question, so take the mic.
Okay.
He's giving the example of somebody smoking, because when somebody's smoking, there is no fire.
Okay.
But there is smoke there.
Uh-huh.
So that's another example of...
Like, what is that example?
Like we had the example of, on the hill, there is... It had rained, the smoke was still coming. So somebody thought there must be a fire, although the fire was doused. Similarly, seeing somebody smoking, somebody may think that there is fire, but actually there is no fire in the case of...
So what he wants to prove from this?
It's same thing that the smoke is not the hetu for...
Oh, smoke is not hetu. How can you say someone is just smoking cigarette?
Yeah.
So you cannot say that smoke is there and no fire. It's fire is there inside. You can touch and feel. Yes or no? So without the fires, nowhere smoke can possible actually. Smoke never produced without fire. So that's why we made smoke as the hetu for the finding the fire. Because so the main relation is what? What kind of relation? Smoke is produced from the only fire. Can you produce smoke without fire in the whole world? Can you do? No. If something is looking like the smoke, that is not smoke. So that is another matter. But real smoke, proper smoke, can you produce without fire? No. So that's why smoke is the hetu for the fire. Okay, next question. Okay. Okay, Prabhu, you can write question to me so that I can take. Siddhari, what you did? He's saying that is not his question.
Yeah.
Defective. Hearing defect.
Okay. Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yes.
Yeah. Prabhuji, the shabd which that person who met them at the junction, he told that those lines.
Yes.
Yeah, that person, you know, whom, yes. Not this is a group, that individual person. Not this guy.
Yeah.
He tells them about hill one and hill two.
Yes.
So that means that he, by his shabda, we are rejecting, the group is rejecting to go to hill one and accepting to go to hill two. Is this correct?
Yes.
Okay. Now, second point of mine, the last point is that why did the, suppose if the group, instead of heading towards hill one, heads towards hill two, because both options are same. Smoke is seen on both the hills. Dono hill pe smoke hai. So, but in your case, they are going towards one. But in my case, they are going towards two. And they meet the same person again. And he tells them, yes, yes, yes. What you are doing is correct. You are going to hill two. Yes, there is fire over there. Then what happens?
So then it's no problem actually. So if he is going, they are going to hill two and they are getting the reconfirmation actually. So because they are going to this hill because they are seeing the smoke, and after the seeing the smoke, so these people immediately applied Anumana Pramana and came to the conclusion that there is a fire on this hill. Okay. So then, but they heard from this person. So there is a fire. So you can go. So this is also possible, but this is not our so required thing. What we want to prove? We want to prove. So Anuman Anumiti Gnanam is dependent on Shabda Gnanam. That much we want to prove. So that's why in example, there are many things are possible, but whatever is required to exemplify, that much only should take. That's the first we started from here. So there are so many features are there in the example that is not necessary for us. No need to both consider that. Okay, that's example Urna Nabi case I give. The spider is there and spider is having so many other features. So it is eating the insects. It doesn't mean that we are comparing with Lord with the spider or the spider. We are using example to explain the Lord. So Lord is also eating the mosquitoes or something. No. That's not necessary. Like this. Now, of course, that is maybe possible. That is not at all a problem for us. Yeah. Yeah. Yes.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yeah.
I just want to clarify that the way we have understood the examples and its application. So like smoke and fire, definitely they are like elements and their relationship is quite implicit and it was easy to understand. I'm just taking one of the Mataji's explanation on Corona, Prabhu, and just want to clarify myself whether I'm applying it correctly.
Yeah, so other students, break time started. So if they want, they can leave. Okay, continue, Prabhu.
So Prabhu, with the corona, if somebody is infected by corona or not, scientists have given certain parameters that these are the symptoms to identify a person is infected or not.
Yes.
On that basis, someone is saying that this person has got A, B, C, D symptoms. And I think he has, we can say that he is corona infected.
Yes.
Now, a doctor comes who has the knowledge of the process to determine whether somebody has corona or not. And he gives sabda pramana that no, this person is not infected. Is that example can be applied like this?
Okay. If you want to apply this kind of example here, so I will explain like this. So you need to make this some little changes. Like you see, A, B, C, D are the symptoms to find the corona. Okay. So corona is the sadhya and A, B, C, D symptoms are the hetu, reason. Okay. Now, so this person is there, person X is there. So person X is there and he is having these ABCD symptoms. And this person X, he is having ABCD symptoms. And now, so you are here and you are observing ABCD symptoms in the person X and coming to the conclusion of corona. He is having corona. So now doctor came. So doctor actually examined him with his real equipments. So these ABCD symptoms actually are not, these ABCD symptoms are there, but the same symptoms are, so you don't know that these same symptoms are possible to another disease also. That is some other disease name is some Y. So you applied these symptoms for finding the corona, but same symptoms are possible for the another also. So then So he is saying that, so these symptoms, whatever you are seeing for corona, those are not exactly, that means sufficient to determine the corona, but I examined the thorough test. And he is not having any corona, he can say like this. So that means here, these symptoms, whatever you use to find the corona, so are not exactly so presenting the corona. So maybe you need to have the some actually not only four to find originally, so maybe some 10, maybe another two symptoms also should match. But you saw only four and you came to conclusion that he's having corona, but doctor is thoroughly verifying this and saying, but actually it is not matching exactly, because here the symptoms and the corona, so the relationship, if it is very strong, then you can apply here in this case. And if it is, and otherwise these symptoms you may find, which are ABCD symptoms, you know, he should have, the patient should have ABCD symptoms, but ABCD symptoms you concluded wrongly. That means those are not really actually ABCD symptom. That is some other symptoms, but you conclude as ABCD and you came to the corona, but he is saying your observation of the symptoms is not proper. And that's why, so he is not at all having the corona, but you are thinking it is corona like this. That is possible. Understanding? ABCD are the symptoms which are useful to find the corona, but you concluded some actually not non-ABCD symptoms as ABCD symptoms, and you said this person is corona patient, and doctor came and he said he is not corona patient, and then you once again rechecked these symptoms properly, and then you came to know, yes, oh, so this ABCD symptoms I concluded wrongly, but he is not having the ABCD symptoms, so he is also not having corona. This kind of conclusion you got, then that is possible.
Thank you, bro. Thanks.
Yes. Yes, yes. Okay, close it. Okay, Mahasev will take.
No, Prabhuji, just I wanted to say that we should not be going to many examples. Instead of that, our focus should be to understand by example what we wanted to understand.
Yes, yes, yes.
And what we wanted to understand is anumiti jnanam is dependent on shabda jnana.
Yes,
so the person came and the person says that, no, don't go to this hill, then go to that hill, that person knows. And we are following. That is the whole point.
Yes.
And if we try to introduce so many examples, we're just wasting the time. That is my point. And it is a struggle, basically. So the take simple example of what Jiva Goswami has given, and that will be very much clear. Humbly, okay.
Okay. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much, Srila Prabhupada. Ki Jai.